Welcome to this tutorial video. Today, we'll explore how to use data sampling and the display objects associated with it. Let's start by creating a data sampling. This can be found in the Data Logging section under Data History tab. This video will focus on setting up the data record. For other settings, please refer to the user manual for additional guidance. In this demo, we will record the data for CPU loading and memory loading. These correspond to LW9025 and LW11159 in the system registers. Let's begin by configuring the first data, and we can save these parameters as defaults to streamline future settings. Next, add the memory loading data to this data sampling. Since the addresses for these two data points are not contiguous, we'll need to uncheck the option for Next Contiguous Address. These two data points will be divided into separate sections, and a single data sample can exist in up to 8 sections simultaneously. Now, let's include the HMI time in this data sampling for reference purposes. The HMI time is stored in contiguous addresses from LW9017 to LW9019, representing second, minute, and hour, respectively. By using the Next Contiguous Address option within the same section, Easy Builder Pro will automatically map the addresses. Let's proceed to add the final setting for the hour. The setup in this section will pull 3 consecutive addresses starting from LW9017. Now we have a simple data sampling configuration. If the data source comes from a PLC, the same rules apply. Next, let's introduce two objects related to data sampling. The first is the trend display object. It will display CPU loading and memory loading data using numeric objects. To set this up, select the trend display object under the same tab to access the settings page. The first step for easy setup is to enable the grid for the trend display. In the channel tab, choose the data to graph and adjust the color and upper and lower limits. For demonstration purposes, I will use the two loading data from non-contiguous addresses. The y-axis scale can also be customized, making it part of the trend display. With these preliminary settings completed, we have successfully configured our first trend display. Now, let's download the project to the HMI to see the results. When you need to observe data differences and chart analysis based on time, this object is the first choice. The second object introduced will be the history data display. In this demonstration, we'll use the sampled data of HMI time to illustrate its functionality. Select the history data display object under the same tab to access the settings page. On the Display Format settings page, you can select the channels that will be displayed. To facilitate user reading, the information for each channel can be labeled clearly in the title tab. This includes fields for second, minute, and hour. After placing the object on the screen, it's time to download and confirm the execution results. Compared to the trend display, the history data display directly shows the values obtained from the data sampling. Isn't that simple? We encourage trying it out in your own applications now. Thanks for watching.